right.
On parade to your left is 31 Platoon, commanded by Lieutenant Angus Cowan. The Platoon Sergeant is Sergeant Solomon Butler. The Second Command is Corporal Caleb Stoppick, Corporal Curtis Willoughby, Corporal Serena Kidman, and Bombardier Michael Aldrich. On parade to your right is 32 Platoon, commanded by Lieutenant Joshua Tong. The Platoon Sergeant is Sergeant Linda Maloney. The Second Commanders are Corporal Beau Pritchard, Corporal Bradley Fortier, Corporal Brianna Munro, and Bombardier Chanda Boston. The Company Sergeant Major will now hand over to the parade commander, Captain Luke Smith, who will then order the officers on parade.
Ladies and gentlemen,
If you are able, please stand while the Governor General's banner is marched on parade. Gentlemen are requested to remove hats and service personnel in uniform should only salute when the banner ensign gives the order to present arms. And the band plays a musical salute when it walks.
March on the banner! Right! General salute! Present arms!
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The banner ensign for today's parade is Lieutenant James Wild. The banner escorts are Sergeant Warren Cooper and Sergeant Gary Mills. The reviewing officer, Director of Logistics Army, Colonel Kane Wright, is now arriving on parade. The reviewing officer is hosted by Officer Commanding Delta Company, Major Jennifer White. Parade commander will now invite the reviewing officer to inspect the parade and band. The custom of inspecting the troops dates back to the mid-1600s, in the time of King Charles II. Its original purpose was to allow the inspecting officer to closely scrutinise each soldier's face and confirm their allegiance, but also be ready for an attempt on his life. Today, the custom continues to confirm the readiness and state discipline of a unit. Thank you. The reviewing officer will now inspect the band. At full capacity, the Australian Army Band Kapooka consists of 26 professional soldier musicians whose versatility allows them to perform in a number of different configurations, including full band, big band, rock band, jazz group, various acoustic and instrumental ensembles, and of course the marching band you see before you today. The band has had a continuous presence at Kapooka since 1951 and proudly supports the Riverina region, as well as having the honour to assist in welcoming each and every one of the Army's newest soldiers as they march out of recruit training. Today, the band is led by Officer Commanding Music Director, Major Greg Peterson, and Drum Major, Sergeant Adrian Malloy. The parade will surely march past in quick time. You are requested to stand when the Governor General's banner passes to your immediate front. Gentlemen are requested to remove hats and service personnel in uniform at a salute when the banner passes to your direct front. Please be seated once the banner has been marched past.
Right, come on,
parade will shortly advance into the water. The significance of this manoeuvre dates back to the 18th century British regiment and was designed to combat the tactical moves of an enemy both in attack and defence. This whole battlefield manoeuvre was conducted with the colours to the front and centre where the commander was also located. All dressing was taken from the colours and the manoeuvre was always carried out with two or more ranks. In our modern ceremony, the parade will advance in review order by marching forward 15 paces at the open order. To mark the end of the manoeuvre, a general salute in the form of present arms will be conducted. Trophies will now be awarded to the best at physical training, the most proficient with weapons, and the Baird VC MG trophy for the most outstanding soldier in each platoon. The winner of the physical proficiency trophy for the best of physical training in 31 platoon is Private Gabriella Stewart, Royal Australian Infantry. The winner of the Skill at Arms Trophy for Weapons Proficiency in 31 Platoon is Private Michael Newton, Royal Australian Army Medical Corps. The winner of the Physical Proficiency Trophy for the best of physical training in 32 Platoon is Private Edward Jones, Royal Australian Corps of Transport. The winner of the Skill at Arms Trophy for Weapons Proficiency in 32 Platoon is Sapper Cody Sislowski, Royal Australian Engineers. The Most Outstanding Soldier Trophy is awarded to the recruit who has achieved above average results in all aspects of recruit training. It has demonstrated beyond reproach the qualities of loyalty, teamwork, integrity, honour and dedication to duty. This award was named for Corporal Cameron Baird, VC MG, who marched out of Kapooka on the 18th of February 2000 and was recognised as the most outstanding soldier of his platoon, having achieved all the recruit course competencies to an excellent standard. The Baird VC MG Trophy for the most outstanding soldier in 31 platoon is awarded to Private Sam Crippy, Royal Australian Corps of Transport. MG Trophy for the most outstanding soldier in 32 platoon is awarded Private Blake Lossop, Royal Australian Corps Military Police. In 2007, Corporal then Lance Corporal Baird was awarded the Medal for Gallantry whilst in action during close quarter combat in Afghanistan on Operation Slipper. In 2014, for his actions on the 22nd of June 2013 during Operation Slipper, he was posthumously awarded the Victorian Cross for Australia for the most conspicuous acts of valour, extreme devotion to duty and ultimate self-sacrifice. Throughout his career, Corporal Cameron Baird, VC, MG, displayed qualities of the highest order, and were in keeping with the finest traditions of the Australian Army and the Australian Defence Force. The Longo Legacy Shield is awarded to the section that achieved the highest score during the recruit's final field exercise. The champion section, the winner of the Longo Legacy Shield, is 3 Section 31 Platoon. The section commander, Vomity Aldridge, will accept this award on behalf of 3 Section. Today, the Legacy Shield is being presented by Mr. Chris Nicol. In 1923, Legacy made a promise to help veterans' families carry on with their lives after the loss or injury of their loved ones. Today, Legacy supports 40,000 partners and children of veterans who gave their lives or help serving our country. The Regimental Sergeant Major Drill Trophy is awarded to the platoon with the highest standard of drill throughout their course and on the march out parade. The Drill Trophy is awarded to 31 and 32 platoons. Receiving this award is the Platoon Sergeant, Sergeant Simon Butler and Sergeant Linda Maloney. The reviewing officer will now address the parade. Police officers on parade. Distinguished guests, family, friends, ladies and gentlemen. It is an honour and a privilege for me to review the March Out Parade of Army's newest soldiers. It is an important occasion for all concerned. I extend a warm welcome to parents, relatives and friends, many of whom have travelled significant distances to be with us. Thank you for your tremendous support over the last few months, and I thank you for trusting to us your most precious possession. We can only build on the qualities and character that you've given them, so thank you for your trust, your support and your faith in the Army as a great national institution, one that turns young men and women into soldiers. I hope you like what we've done with them. The transformation did not happen by accident. During the past 63 days, these soldiers have been trained, led, nurtured and encouraged by the staff of the 1st Recruit Training Battalion, dedicated to ensuring their success. The staff are the very best that Army has available. Many of them are veterans of our current conflicts and know only too well the challenges that lay ahead for our newest soldiers. The NCOs and officers before you have insisted that rigorous standards are maintained, as they know one day their own lives may be in the hands of those that they have trained. It would be remiss of me not to acknowledge the Army being Kapooka. Your performance not only today but on all of the occasions when you represent the finest traditions of the Army is greatly admired and appreciated. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in thanking Greg and the Australian Army Band for Kapooka. But today belongs to our soldiers on parade, and let me focus on you. I would like to congratulate the prize winners on their achievements, but today is not just about those individuals, it is about the team. In this regard, you are all winners. We've all achieved a great deal since you arrived. Soldiers like Private Mia Edwardson. Mia, your main cap is here today, and I know that she is incredibly proud of you. Some of you have made significant personal sacrifices to become a soldier. You may have left behind wives, husbands, partners, in some cases even children. As an example, I understand Private Glossop may have foregone a potentially lucrative career as a mixed martial arts fighter to come and become a soldier. Well done, mate. But it is worth it. You have demonstrated your commitment to a demanding career and a unique way of life. This is definitely not a 9-to-5 job. You were told at the outset that the transformation from civilian to soldier was not easy, but that it was achievable. And here you are, marching out now from the home of the soldier. I know I speak for everyone watching the parade and saying that your performance here today should be a source of great pride to you, your family and friends, and everyone associated with the 1st Recruit Training Battalion. Let me congratulate you all on this achievement. You have achieved an excellent overall parade standard. Well done. Our success as an Army relies squarely on you, our soldiers. That success has never been the result of large-scale mass, or extraordinary technology, or unlimited firepower. What has made us one of the best armies in the world is our ability to embody and live the military ethic and the ADF's five values of service, courage, respect, integrity, and excellence. We are a values-based army. This is how we endured the horrors of the Somme in the First World War. Fought back our foes on the Kapooka track in the Second World War. Sustained ourselves against legions of enemy at the Battle of Kapyong in Korea. Held firm against thousands of determined enemy in the Battle of Long Beach in South Vietnam. It's how we led a 21-nation coalition to success in East Timor and brought a better life to countless local people in Al Mithama province, Iraq, and Luzon province, Afghanistan. Those same values that sustain soldiers of those campaigns will sustain you in yours. So my key message to you here today is to hold on to the values that you've been taught here and be a values-based soldier in a values-based army. And so the final thought is that you are now in a position to leave your own legacy. You are now part of Australia's great national institution, its army. This is the first great milestone of your careers, and the soldiers have well and truly deserved the celebrations of today. While you all arrive from different backgrounds, today you share a common bond. You have all earned the right to serve with honour in the Australian Army. In closing, to you, our newest soldiers, always remember our contract with Australia, a contract that is now yours. You are an Australian soldier who is an expert in close combat. You are physically and mentally tough, compassionate and courageous. You live by integrity. You strive to take the initiative. You are committed to learning and working for the team. You believe in trust, loyalty, and respect for your country, your mates and the Army. The rising sun is your badge of honour. You are an Australian soldier. Welcome to the profession of arms. Good luck and good soldiering. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are able, please stand for the playing of the national anthem. Gentlemen are requested to remove hats and service personnel in uniform arms and service. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The reviewing officer from the other part of the crowd. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are able, please stand and remain standing as the Governor General's banner is marched off the parade. Gentlemen are requested to remove hats and service personnel in uniform should only salute when the parade commander gives the order to present arms and the band plays the musical salute in front of the order.
March off the banner!
Thank you.
The brave man up will now call out the officers. It is requested that you please remain within the standing enclosure until after the band has left the parade ground.